fish has been painted a lot of times by just one more take on it. First thing we've done, we've sealed the fish, then we painted it white, and then we're going to go over it with white pearls. Just going to put a good coat of pearl all over the whole fish. And the sides real good. Okay, now what I've got a Q-tip, and I want to put a little on a little lac thinner on the end of it. Roll it one time on my pant leg or a paper towel so it doesn't drip. And now I just clean my off. If you don't do it now, and just do it after you finish painting the fish, a lot of times you have a little bit of a white ring, and it's noticeable. So if you can go ahead and clean your eye off now, I think it's a plus. Get off, you're not going to have that a big old white ring around your eye. Okay, now I've got yellow. I want to get the breast area. Get the main body. About a light to medium coat. Stronger along the lower belly, and in the midsection, you want it lighter in the midsection. Still want it noticeable. And you want it on top too. Looks pretty good. You can still see the pearl through it. Also put a light coat on your fins. On all your fins. Cheek area. Either paint a leaf. You can leave the breast alone because we're going to go with orange later, or you can go ahead and just leave the yellow there too. Okay, that's pretty good. About a light coat, maybe lighter in the middle, because you want that pearly violet color to show up on your bluegill, like a male spawning bluegill would have. And so that's the reason why. We don't want to cover it up with just plain yellow. But let your individual fish determine how you paint it. Because they all differ. Now if you feel like your yellow is not pearly enough, you probably put a little bit of yellow pearl over your yellow. But it's plenty pearly enough for me. And if you feel like you darken your midsection in too much, you can go back over with a little bit of white pearl, and it'll kind of phase it back out a little bit. Okay, if you feel like you got to lighten up your midsection, I've just got my pearl again, and it'll lighten your yellow up, and you still have your pearly effect. That's if you think you need to. Okay, now I've got the orange. It's the opaque variety of orange. A bright orange or a vivid orange, something like that. It's perfect. And you want to put about a medium coat and fade by the time you get to these pelvic fins. Right there. With about a medium coat. Now these bluegill, they differ so much according to the spawn. There's so many varieties. I've seen them just real dark and purple, violet color. They come in such a wide variety of colors. And the thing about bluegill, you want it to fade out right here at the pectorals. And about a medium coat. And if you do put some on the side, you can put it on real lightly, just off the yellow. Make it more of a... You're doing almost what gold toner would do, in other words. Just maybe toning the yellow down a little. I mean, that's how light you're putting it on. But the main thing is the breast area. And then you want it just to kind of fade out. Okay, now I've got medium green. And what I want to do is, I don't want to kill my yellow out completely, but I want to go over it with the medium green and fade out at the lateral line. Right here at the lateral line, fairly abruptly right here at the lateral line. You can, maybe just a little bit below lateral line you can go, but if you can stop it fairly abruptly right there at the lateral line, that's good. And here again, you don't want to necessarily kill out your yellow, but you want it to look like exactly what it is. Which may take several passes for you to get exactly what you're trying to achieve. And also, you want to use this lightly on your fins. And that's about good enough. Even a little on the around the eyes, upper part of the cheek and the gills. A light green, a tint to the fins is perfect. More so on the inside of the fin. The thing about a bluegill, they vary so much in color, from a dark purple with Payne's gray fins. They vary intensely from region to region. Make sure that green fades. Put it on where you know that when you go over it with another color, that you'll be able to distinguish a difference. So about a medium light coat over the yellow. And the yellow still does its part because it's keeping your green from being quite as dark as you want it to be. And there you go. An orange color. Riding up a little bit on the, that almost like a gold toner type color, and that's what you're after. Lightly. Lighten the fins, about a medium light coat, and you want it to fade out at the lateral line. Got violet. And for the intensity of the violet, you probably want to, here again, use your reference. I think it's a more of a spawning color, and some fish may exhibit it more than others. And I even like to go on to the orange a little bit with it, just lightly. And go right almost down to the fins, but not quite with it. And then I stop at the lateral line. I think this is more of a spawning bluegill color. But I stop right here at the lateral line. Now the intensity of your violet, you need to determine that according to your particular fish, I think. But you do want it to see, you want it to show, you want it to kind of blend with your other colors. And you can even put a little bit lightly on the cheek and gill flap. And you want it to stop also at the lateral line. And it wouldn't be wrong to put a little bit on your fins if you want to. The thing is, you want it to ride up to the lateral line. Maybe get a little on the gill flap. Just a little in the cheek area. And then you want it to smooth down into this. And I even go into the orange with it a little. Just for a good blending effect. But I don't think I'm going to put it on heavy enough in this case to cover that little bit of yellow that I put underneath it. Okay, now for the spotting of the fin. Here again, just like I do with any fish, I will tend to do my barring and body details before I start darkening the back and stuff like that. And I've got my airbrush thinned down and my paint thinned down fairly good. So I can have good adequate flow. Now even these bars differ from fish to fish. Sometimes they're almost like two bars real close together. And sometimes it's just like they're one bar. So. Here again, they can differ. Here again, you want your fish as straight up and down as humanly possible. That is so your bars are straight. And if you don't do that, you're going to have crooked bars. And you can do the half moon effect. You may want to mist them in first. And that way you know they're going straight up and down. Here again, the bluegill, they vary so much and in so many ways, it is really kind of hard to
to pinpoint one exact way that they look, per se.
Done that, then you can go back and start trying to really try to and what I do is almost a half moon going away from your bar that you're trying to make as you make the bar, and it has a pretty good effect, it seems like. Now, even the intensity of the bars can vary, determine several factors can determine that. Bluegills, you may decide you want to make some pretty good dark bars. And you want them distinguishable. And sometimes they exhibit almost a hollowness in the middle of them, and I'm going to leave that up to you to determine whether you want to replicate that or not. Actually a little straighter than they need to be. They, here again, they're not perfect. Although they're irregular, they're not perfect up and down bars, in other words. So I'd be wrong to say that they just go one way. But as you approach towards the bottom of the fish, they'll tend to get lighter and fizzle out. And it's not wrong to put that in your fish. It's not wrong to do that, in other words. It's not perfect. Idea not to make them so regular. Try to break them up a little if you can. Just remember, as you get towards the bottom, you want them to fade completely out if you can. Turn your airbrush for this down. You may have to turn your airbrush down for this too. Maybe make a few go up, you don't get carried away. In other words, it's not a small amount by any means. Too much around the top of the head. You may want to put some spotting, especially towards this front section of the head. I've seen them have spots like that. So it's not wrong to do that. And even on the head, I guess. Even down here on the horn, you'll Use your reference or a good picture, and it'll show you exactly how it does. Then you just replicate it.
Do some darkening, using the same color, black green. Same color we use for the bars.
I've got my black green. Get from an angle. I want the paint to glance off the side of the fish and just go out into the air. But what paint does hit the fish from such an extreme forward angle, it's highlighting the scales on the side of the fish. And so that's my goal right now. I want to tone my bars in and bring out my scales out. When I bring my scales out, what I'm doing is toning my bars in. And I'm also darkening the fish. But if you can see, I'm bringing scales out. And here's where it helps have good reference to see just how dark you want your fish. Okay, that looks pretty good already. And you want to hit them scales and bring them out. That is a hit from an angle. And yeah, it's bringing them out. You're also darkening the fish, but you're bringing the scales out. So you're kind of darkening it, but in a good, legitimate way, you're doing it. And you can even darken the breast up. Green. And you can highlight your scales on your breast by angle spraying a little from the front. And what it'll do, it'll bring out some of them. You can bring out some of the scales in the fish, but you're bringing the scales out. And that always makes for a more realistic looking fish. Okay, now what I'm doing is, I usually start from the top, but since I got it like this, I'll do it from the bottom. You just want to angle spray, and the purpose is to bring the rays out the fin. And all I'm doing is hitting from an extreme angle, bring the rays out. And the darkness of the fin you need to determine by the rest of the fish. Or if you're already comfortable with your airbrush, you know that it's really sort of hard to mess one of these guys up. But I'm just bringing the rays out of the fins. But from an angle with my airbrush. I mean, from the extreme frontal angle, you may have to readjust your pressure on your airbrush if it's blowing too hard or not enough. When you color the fin too, you can hold it out where you're hitting some of the inside of the, in between the fins too, and it darkens the whole fish up in general. And then, of course, you do the tail. Did a little bit of a spot pattern on their fins, and if you feel necessary, replicate that. I guess what I'm trying to say is, I've even seen smallmouth that have had a little bit of a spot pattern on this pectoral fin, and I don't know if it was just one of those fluke things, and you don't see it every day, but. There again, different fish will exhibit different slots. Then, now we just darken the outer edges of the fins. Fins, I go in with a rolling motion in between my spiny ribs and my spiny dorsal. And I've always done every fish that way. Like this. And I don't go all the way down, just the very top. And I try not to make it real intense, but intense enough. But if you feel like if you made it too intense, you can come back over an angle spray and bring those, make it where it's the that dark print on your outer extremity is not so overwhelming. You just want to kind of phase it in. About like that. And the same with the tail. You just kind of want to kind of stipple it in, I guess is the right word. Kind of like stippling. You just get right there on the edge. And then you want it to flush into the body. Use a little bit of darkness to flush the bottom of your tail into the body. And the same with the top. Use some of that darkness to flush the top of your tail into the body. And if you feel like you got to darken the fin up a little, now's the time to do it. Okay. Come in from an outer angle, so forth. Now the same with the shell crackers. Sometimes I've gotten shell crackers, they're so dark, their fins are basically a black, or, you know, a black-green. Very, very, very dark. Sometimes. Okay, come in, just do the bottom one third of the fin. Do the back in the same way. Now the pectorals is the same. You just gotta do the upper one third of it. Okay. Now, I reserve the right. We may have to go back and darken the fins up later. We still got to do mouth work and top of the head. So we're going to put my black green again. Right here, there's a dip in the nose right here on top of the fish. Just like my bluegill and everything, I start right there. Or my bass or anything, there's a dip right there in the top, right between, it's the nose. Right on top of the upper mouth, there's a dip. Kind of like the dip we got on our upper lip. It's the same thing on a fish, that dip. And I start there. And to paint the lip, I'll paint the lip. And I let the overspray from paint the lip hit that back maxillary. And also that other stuff. And it darkens all that stuff up. And I do the same the other side. So overspray can be your friend. And this is a closed mouth, but I usually get in between there real good. Now right here on the lower jaw, I get the tip of the mouth. I bring that black spray down on each side of the lower jaw a little bit. You can let the overspray hit this side. Now if this was an open mouth, I'd see a little bit of that dip in the nose, the side of it. I'd want to darken it up too. And also darken around the eyes and this carapace. It's not a carapace, but all fish got it. It comes down and goes around the eye. And I darken all that. You probably don't want to go too extremely dark. You don't want to go black. There again, you have to let your reference of your particular fish. And if you see a chance to bring out some more scale details, go ahead and do it. And do the same thing to the other side. And then, okay, after I go around the eye, then I'll come up into here. Ooh, some of that darkness is making the scale stand out real good. So I probably want to use that and keep that. Okay, now I'm going to turn the fish sideways so I can get his back. And just right up on the very top. And do both sides. The back is always the darkest part of every fish. Now when I make a sweep, I'll go right up the top of the back and let some of the spray hit the base of the dorsals. The base of the dorsals will get a little bit of it, as well as the back. And now I'm starting. And then you want the black to feather out before you come all the way down. Although you use this black green to shade your whole fish, and it does a good job bringing out all your scales on your fish, as you can see. But at the same time, you want to make sure that the back is the darkest part of your fish, because it's just the back sees the most sun, and it tends to be the darkest part of the fish. But I would say blend those bars in a little bit. You can even put a few more marks, but be careful. You can put so many marks in between the bars of this bluegill that you make your bars disappear. I've been guilty of doing that on my smallmouth, and it's not good to do it. On fish that have bars, in other words, just be careful that you don't make all the bars and everything disappear. Now remember, how much you darkening, that is your own preference and your own reference. You will see some spotting on the fins. And I don't think all bluegills exhibit them. I think the green sunfish will exhibit it. And I've just got my black green again. Now, right up here on this one, just kind of like a dark spot right there. But I've also seen it here on the bottom, like that. So it's not wrong to put them on both, although a lot of times people just put them on the upper one. The pale blue, and even the blue on the bluegills on different fish exhibit different colors. Sometimes it's more of a turquoise, almost a teal green color. But according to my reference, the blue kind of comes out from the back of the so it starts right around where the black ends, almost like it comes around from the back of it. There's like a row of scales. That first row of scales gets it. It acts like it wants to come up into here a little. Right down in here, it gets all this too. So it covers a lot more than what people think it does. Even a little bit on the lower part of the cheek seems to get. It gets all that. Part of the maxillary. Exhibit different characteristics. Obviously. And I could put this on and dress your lower lip up again. Maybe a little bit on the side. And it wouldn't be wrong for Little to be on the Max Hillary. Because I've seen it there. But this lower gill flap area here, and as far as the gill rays themselves, I suppose you could paint those blue if you wanted to, but I'd probably just leave those. Your particular reference to your bluegill will let you determine better how you need to put your blue on for your bluegill. And on a shellcracker, this is round, about on a big shellcracker, about as round as a dime. And oval-shaped, a little bit more. Oval-shaped and about as round as a dime. And round. On a shellcracker, they're oval-shaped. That black area, but on a bluegill, they don't do that. So that's one difference between a shellcracker and a bluegill. Hold the pinner on a Q-tip and roll it one time on your pant leg or a paper towel, preferably, so that the excess is not in your Q-tip and it doesn't want to run down your paint job. But then you go ahead and clean your eye off. Like so forth. And when you put a gloss on, it's going to bring out all them pearls underneath your colors, and your gloss is going to bring everything out. You'll have a wonderful looking fish. Now I've got gloss, and I like to use polyurethane gloss. Makes everything have a good looking wet look gloss. The Taxidermy Supplies companies have got some real good glosses on the market. And this is just gloss top coat. And you want to put a light color over it first to set the paint. And then you go back with some heavier paint. And then you let that dry for a few minutes on the film. But you go back with a thicker, heavier coat. It's fair to put your paints on in layers too. Put another and another. A lot of times I'll set the paint with gloss top coat, then I'll go back over with polyurethane gloss or even some of the wet look gloss and stuff like that that they got in the taxidermy supply companies. And you want a gloss that's not so shimmery that it reflects everything. You want a gloss that when you put it on, it gives you depth as well as shine. But this is how I paint a bluegill. Something else I didn't mention is the black green that you used, the last color you used, it's good for painting the back of your fins with, and that's the black green. A couple of other things I was wanting